we've all heard of things like Siri, Alexa, self-driving cars, Netflix, and Google. In the last video, I told you the secret to the success of all these cool gadgets and apps, artificial intelligence. But wouldn't it be cool to know how exactly these things work? How can Alexa understand what we're saying and talk back to us, as though she's just any other human? How can a car possibly drive itself? Well, the answers to all these questions lie in the inner workings of the many powerful branches of artificial intelligence. Note that the intersection of the branches depicted here is subject to interpretation, and you may see differences in the way that these are presented elsewhere. But the goal with this video is to provide you with an introduction to the basics of each of these. I'd also like you to note that the field of AI is significantly more vast than the previous diagram, as you can see here, but we'll come to that in later videos. And don't forget to download the interactive PDF linked in the description below so that you can take valuable notes on key points to take away from this video. Let's get started. So for AI to drive the world's most advanced technology, it must be some kind of superpower, right? Yes, but it's not just a single unit that runs the show. AI has hundreds of branches that each serve different purposes and come together at the end to create something wonderful. It's these branches that make AI a little less artificial and that much more intelligent. The easiest way to think about it would be to compare it to a human. After all, AI machines try to work and act just like humans. This is Steve. When Steve was born, he enters a whole new world of strange sights and sounds. As he grows up, he starts to understand human language and learns to communicate with others. This is one of the most basic and easy actions for a human to grasp. But for computers? Not so easy. Well, that's until the emergence of AI. With natural language processing, or NLP, it all changes. NLP is the branch of AI that deals with the interaction between humans and computers. Basically, there are two primary ways in which humans interact with computers, through text and voice. Let's look at text first. So when the computer receives the text input, it processes it using various techniques, such as parsing, segmentation, stemming, etc., which all broadly come under this field of NLP. Next, let's look at voice input. When the computer receives the voice input, it captures the audio and converts it into text. The steps we just talked about for processing text repeats. Finally, the machine translates its response into an audio file that it plays back to the human. Let's look at a few practical examples you may be familiar with. Ever use Google Translate, Microsoft Word, Siri, or Grammarly? Well, these apps are possible thanks to natural language processing. Now we know that in the case of text input, NLP enabled the machine to take in a statement, figure out its meaning, and respond back with valuable output. But in the case where the input was voice, how was the computer able to understand the sounds coming out of the person's mouth? I mean, humans can hear words and understand the meaning and intent of those words. But how does a computer know how to put different vowel and consonant sounds together to form complete words and sentences in our human language? Well, that takes us to our next branch, speech recognition, that allows the computer to do just this. When Sarah speaks, the computer is able to understand and process her words using speech recognition and can output valuable information that Sarah can understand. At a high level, speech recognition uses a tool called a spectrogram to pull out frequencies of sounds. It then compares these frequencies to establish vowel and consonant sounds to figure out what sounds the person made. Finally, it connects these sounds together to form complete words and eventually sentences that NLP then uses to figure out the meaning of those words. So now you've learned the fundamentals of speech recognition that allows the computer to understand human sounds. Now back to Steve. So as Steve grows, he also learns to see and interpret different things around him. This ability is something that most humans take for granted, but just imagine how different life would be if we couldn't see anything around us or understand what they are. Well, this was the case for computers for most of history. They could not process much of the data available, such as images and videos of people, plants, animals, etc., making them extremely limited in their abilities. But then came the branch of AI called computer vision that changed it all. Computer vision gives machines the ability to acquire, process, and analyze digital images. They can use this information to find patterns and make decisions. How does an iPhone unlock itself as soon as you show it your face? Computer vision. How does a self-driving car know exactly where to go? Computer vision. So as you can see, computer vision is incredibly powerful and can do amazing things. So I've told you that computer vision gives a self-driving car the ability to detect objects around it. But how does a car have the ability to drive itself without anyone powering its movement? This is because of the branch of robotics and autonomous systems. Autonomous robots sense their environment by using various technologies, such as cameras, infrared and ultrasound sensors, scanners, and microphones. Additionally, they use computer vision to see any obstacles in their way. So this is a brief introduction to the subfields of robotics and autonomous systems. So we've seen that the computer, using the power of NLP, speech recognition, and computer vision, can intelligently process text, audio, and images. Oftentimes, with these data types, there are also patterns that would be helpful for the computer to understand. For example, irregularities in medical scans could be immensely useful in early detection of potential health issues, or perhaps detection of patterns of word usage in emails can help detect if the email should be auto-classified as spam or not. These are made possible using the field of AI called pattern recognition. So pattern recognition allows the machine to recognize regularities and irregularities of data. And finally, onto our last branch of AI, arguably the most powerful one. Now, we all know that humans have the ability to distinguish between things that are different. For example, it's easy for us to identify a dog versus a cat. Throughout our lives, we've been shown numerous images of both of these animals, so by now we know exactly how to tell them apart. But until now, it's not been so simple for a computer, because the computer didn't have the intelligence to pinpoint exactly what differentiates between the two, enough to identify an animal given a picture that it's never seen before. That is, until the branch of machine learning developed. Just as a human does, machine learning allows computers to learn from experience. Basically, humans can feed a computer hundreds of images of cats and dogs, and eventually the computer will learn how to distinguish between the two. And over time, it gets better and better. So at a high level, this is the essence of machine learning. So now you've learned about the basics of the primary fields of AI. As a quick summary, we have NLP, which allows computers to interact with humans, speech recognition, which allows machines to understand human sounds, computer vision, which allows machines to see and process images and videos, pattern recognition, which allows computers to analyze regularities and patterns, robotics and autonomous systems, which allow machines to move about on their own, and machine learning, which allows computers to predict and improve themselves based on data and experience. So now that you know about the basics of AI, you're well prepared to start learning about the branches of AI in more depth. Over the course of the next few videos, we're going to be diving into the branch of natural language processing. At the end of the series, we have an interesting project that'll tie everything together and give you something cool to show your friends and family. So stay tuned for that. If you've liked the content in this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below on what branch sounds most interesting to you, and if you've ever seen anything powered by that branch. And if you're new here, then make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss any videos that'll help you on your journey towards mastering artificial intelligence. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.